Good morning, dear students. Myself Vikas Prajapati, assistant professor from Sri Sitaram Bainerji Patel Institute of Technology and Research Center, Umrak. In semester 3, one common subject for all branches, that is effective technical communication. The subject code is 313004. Today I will teach you on topic of group discussion. First of all, what is group discussions? In group discussion, a particular number of people, approximately 3 to 8 people, meet face to face and they are doing free oral interactions for the purpose of to develop, share and discuss ideas. Group discussions are widely used in organizations for decision making and problem solving purpose. Group discussion also used as a personality test for evaluating several candidates simultaneously. Group discussion help to shortlist candidates for a final interview. Now, categories of group discussion. There are two main categories of group discussion: organizational group discussion and group discussion as a part of a selection process. Now, first one. Organizational group discussion. In an organization, group discussion used for the purpose of decision making and problem solving. In organizational GD, there are basically 3 techniques are available. First one, brainstorming. Second, nominal group technique. Third one, brainstorming. It is the method for generating a variety of ideas and perspectives related to particular topic. It is as uncritical as possible because criticism inhibits the free flow of ideas. In this method, 6 to 12 persons sit around a table. Problem is stated clearly by a group leader. The suggestions given with a stipulated time by members by writing down on a blackboard, whiteboard, flip chart or a piece of paper. No criticism is allowed and alternatives are recorded for discussion and analysis. There are 2 types of brainstorming techniques. First one, that is storyboarding, and second one, that is storyboarding. In this technique, participants identify the major issues and brainstorm each of them in a particular story. Now B, that is lotus blossom. According to author, each lotus have at least 8 petals. So in this method, all the participants have to identify the major issues, and on each major issues you have to write down the at least 8 ideas, and that method are called the lotus blow. B, nominal group technique. Nominal group technique restrict the discussion or interpersonal communications during the decision making process, and hence the term nominal group. In this technique, group members are all physically present, that is highly required. It's just like a traditional committee meeting. They operate independently. In this method also, you have to follow the some steps. First of all, the problem is presented, and then members independently and silently write down his or her idea on the problem before any discussions. Then after, each member silently and independently rank orders the ideas. Third one, that is the one with the highest aggregate ranking, is the final decision. So in this method, one thing is added, that is as a member you are writing different ideas, but you have to give rank also. Rank, or we can say that order to that idea, and on the basis of aggregate average, highest aggregate average, final decision will be Delphi method. Delphi It's a very complex and time-consuming technique. It is similar to the nominal group technique, except one thing, that is, in a nominal group technique, physical presence is required. In a Delphi technique, each and every member's physical presence are not required. In Delphi technique, you have to follow some of the steps. First one, that is, problem is identified and members are to provide potential solution through a series of careful design questionnaire. Problems aapko kaha jayega and all of you prepare the one questionnaire on problem. Then after, each member independently completes the first questionnaire, then find out the results and submit it to higher authority. Then higher authority will rotate the result. For example, like there are three people are there, A, B and C, then higher authority will pass the result of A to B, B to C and C to A. Then again, all of you edit this questionnaire, then again fill up and complete this questionnaire, then after find the result and submit it to higher authority. Then again higher authority rotate the result. That process is continuously. These two steps you have to follow at repeatedly up to the stage where there are no consequences are available. No, all the members have worked on that questionnaire, then result become excellent because there are no possibility of any fault. So that technique is very effective, but it's a little bit complex and time consuming technique. Now second category, that is group discussion as a part of selection process. Group discussions for the selection of candidate for a job or for admissions are well formulated devices for the judging the personality of candidates, their communication skill, knowledge and their ability to work as a team. Group discussion have become an integral part of most selection processes today. Nowadays, majority of the organizations use the group discussion as a part of selection process. They are first take the written test, and then after, majority of the companies prefer group discussion also, because with the help of group discussions, company shortlist very few candidates for a final interview. And with the help of group discussions, company will check the candidate's knowledge related to particular topic, as well as his or her communication skill, as well as the group behavior of the candidate, then after the leadership skill of candidate. Employers look for candidate who have the potential to shoulder responsibility and provide leadership. That is leadership. I have already talked about that. Then after, check your team playing skill, that is group behavior, individual traits, that is your knowledge related to particular topic, group behavior and leadership quality. That will check with the help of group discussion. Then after, second point, that is evaluation component in group discussion. Basically, with the help of group discussions, these are the five major things that you can, any organizations, they are evaluating this four major components, that is knowledge of candidate, communication skill of candidate, then after group behavior of candidate and leadership skills available in candidate or not. Now let's detail. First one, that is knowledge. Knowledge refers to the depth and range of your knowledge as well as your analytical and organizational ability. Employer will expect the in-depth knowledge related to particular topic, as well as your analytical and organizational ability, because as a good candidate you require analytical as well as organizational abilities related to particular topic also. You should be able to grab the situations and analyze it not just at a lower level but from the wider perspective also. You have to give the maximum contributions in a particular decisions. Then after number two, that is communication skill. With the help of group discussion, employer will check your communication skill. Communication skill is a very broader topic that cover your active listening ability, clarity of thoughts and expression, appropriate language, active listening. Listening is an important as speaking in a group discussion. Without listening to others, you may not be able to continue the discussion in the right direction. So, as an employer, they will check the all participants' listening ability. They are doing active listening or they are doing passive listening. On the basis of that, employers and expression, clarity of thoughts and expressions. Communication skill cover the clarity of thoughts and expressions that cover your tone, your quality of content, your voice, your articulation, your fluency in speaking and writing, your voice modulations, and your delivering method. That all are covered under the banner of clarity of thoughts and expressions. Then after, appropriate language. Your language should be accurate, free of grammatical error. Also, it should be direct, clear and precise, with your ideas flowing in an organization fashion. Do not use the long sentences. You have to use the simple sentences, and rather you should try to keep your language simple. Do not use jargon which neither your group mates nor you understands. You have to use the simple terminology. Appropriate body language. At the time of group discussion, your gesture, posture, as well as your emotions, that also analyze. So as per the situations, you have to control your emotions, just like you are anger, frustrated, you are excitement, that you have to not show in group discussion. Then after, your gesture, posture, that become appropriate, that is highly required. Now group behavior, that is your emotional maturity and balance promotes the good interpersonal relationship. During group discussion is a group activity, it's not at all individual activity. So participating involves coordination and cooperation among the various members, that is highly required. For example, like there are 30 minutes available for group discussion and only 2-3 people are speaking for 25 minutes and other people have no time, so it's not at all appropriate group discussion. So you have to allocate the appropriate time to each and every members, because it's a group activity. If some of the members are silently, then you have to encourage them to speak, because if you are able to work in a, if you are doing good work in a group, then your work in a organization also good, because in an organization there are different departments are available, means you have to work in a group. So group behavior, if you have a good group behavior, then you can survive very well in an organization. Then after, leadership skill. A group cannot carry on its assigned work effectively without a leader. Group discussions always required one informal leaders. During group discussions, you feel that all the members are silently, then you have to play a role of initiator and control the whole group discussion. During the group discussion, you can play a role of concluder, or so you can play a role of linker also. So it's a, that will shows your leadership skill during the group discussion. Now, some of the tips for success in group discussion. Be through with current issues. When you are going for group discussion, then at least you have to aware about some what are the current issues. Always enter the room with a piece of paper and pen. It's a good habit. Listen to the topic carefully. Jot down as many ideas you can in the first few minutes. Then after, try to discuss the topic and go into the underlying causes. Organize your ideas before you speaking. Speak first only if you have something sensible to say. Try to contribute meaningfully. Identify your supporter and opponents. Keep track on the time. Set time fairly. Have an open mind and listen to also. Maintain eye contact while speaking and listening. Display a spirit of good cooperation. Draw out the silent member and encourage them to speak. So these are some of the common tips for successful group discussion. Thank you all of you.